trying to understand where condition. Right now we are doing a sample query to retrieve all the records. We retrieve all the records from the database. I don't want to retrieve all the data. I want to apply some filter condition and retrieve the data. So how do you apply the filter condition? Where field name operator now we are going to write where field name operator value the operator can be less than greater than equal whatever it is field name operator value so I am going to write where name equal to wipro where industry equal to energy where stage name equal to closed one we are applying the where condition we are applying the filter condition getting the data trying to display you may need to write multiple conditions also where you want to write multiple condition again it is going to be where field name operator value and or field name operator you may write condition 1 and condition 2 or condition 1 or condition 2 condition 1 and condition 2 condition 1 or condition 2 we are writing multiple condition here so where I am giving where name equal to is force and industry equal to banking we give where lead source equal to web or rating not equal to rating not equal to we are giving multiple condition so if you want to apply the filter condition select fields from s object where condition select fields from s object where condition let me implement one example so go to the developer console so I'm giving here select name phone industry from account where industry equal to I give a condition where industry equal to energy execute we received 3 records select name phone industry from account where rating equal to walk where rating equal to walk there again 3 records where are getting my point so select a fields from s object where condition where field name equal to value where field name equal to value the same thing I want to apply dynamically this is a straight away value I have given but I want to apply dynamically if you want to apply dynamically I have a condition like this I have a bf page then I told then I give input text box when I enter the data click on the search here I may give account name or industry any one of the value I may give account name or I may give industry I can search the account record based on name or industry. I can search for the account record based on the name or industry. I can search for the record based on the name or industry. We can search for the record based on name or industry. When I click on this, get me all the records whose name is matching with that, or whose industry is matching with that. Are you getting my point? So I am giving here a box. In this box, you can search based on name or industry. Anyone. I gave a box. You can search based on name or industry. When you click on this, get me the records, display the records. Okay. Now, let us see this one. Sample example 4. Public string getting public list of account is yes, set get public string search text. You are going to enter some search text. Based on the data, we are going to retrieve the information. So how are you retrieving? What is the value of ACCS? What is the value of ACCS? Null. It is a reference variable. Memory is not allocated. So what I am doing? ACCS equal to select the name, industry, phone, type from account where name equal to. Why did I give a colon? If I am referring to a variable, we need to use colon followed by variable. Name and name or industry equal to. Industry equal to. Name equal to the search text or industry equal to the search text. Why it won't? You may search based on name or search based on industry. Once you got this data, I want to display it. Now, whatever the records you got, I want to sort them in the ascending order and display. How do you sort them in ascending order? ACCS dot. The data what I received, I can sort them. Now when you sort, basically they go with the sorting of name field. But I don't want to sort based on name field, I want to sort based on any other field. Then again we go with the one more class in the query. Right now, we wrote a where condition, we got the data, I want to display. I hope I am clear. Basic query is clear. Then go back to this. BF page. Page block reference location equal to top. The main button value equal to action equal to value equal to search, action equal to search. This is the format I gave. You want to display the data. How do you display the data? Page block table value equal to value equal to dot name. What are the fields I retrieved? Name, industry, phone. Listed phone type. This is the same what we are doing from last, what we have done in the last class. But I want to keep this box. I want to keep this box outside the page block. I want to keep this block outside the page block. I want to give effects input text value equal to input text command button value equal to such, action equal to such. Now, when there is no data, is there any meaning in displaying the page block? Don't display the page block when there are no records. So what I can do? Rendered, re-render is what? Refresh. Render is what? Display or not. Rendered. When? Is not null. When ACCC is not null, re-render when ACCC is not equal to null. Go with this format. Basically, until you click on the search button, there is no data. Am I right? What is the value of ACCS? Null. Only when you click on the search, we are getting the data. So go back. Then I am giving. They are getting the data based on energy. No boss, I want to search based on the name. They are getting the data based on this. Right. If I don't enter any data, if I don't enter anything, industry equal to blank. Where industry equal to blank. So export doesn't have industry, so they are giving where industry equal to blank. Right. People are clear? Basically, we are writing a where condition. People are clear with this example? Where name equal to so-and-so, value equal to so-and-so. Now, let us go to the next example. I am going to expand. Look at my next format. Now, I want search to be performed like this. I have a box. Save. Name, I have a box, and I am clicking on search button. Now, when I am clicking on the search, if I don't enter anything in the name, fine, let me not take name also. Let me take empty box. If you don't enter anything in the box, then what is the value of such text? If I don't enter any value, what is the value of such text? Null. Now, if I don't enter any value in the such text, is there any meaning in writing a where condition? Where name equal to such text? When there is no value in the such text, there is no need of writing a where condition. I will write a where condition only when there is a value in the such. Are you getting my point? If the value was there, then write the where condition. If the value is not there, don't write the where condition. Now, listen to the problem. This is what is called dynamic software coding. So what I am doing here, let me shorten this. I am creating a condition. What is the condition? First, string, I am writing a query. Query equal to select name, industry, phone, from. This is a fixed query, boss. Now the question is, if you enter any name in the box, write where condition. If you don't enter any value in the box, only select name, industry, phone, from account. If you enter any value in the search box, then where name equal to search box or industry equal to search box. If I don't enter any value in the search box, no where condition. If you provide a condition, I will verify. If you don't provide any value, there is no where condition, right? So what I am doing, if search text not equal to null, and such text not equal to blank. Such text is not equal to null and not equal to blank. What does it mean? It is not null, it is blank. It is not blank. That means value is entered. It is not null, it is not blank means what? Value is entered. When the value is entered, what should I do? I have to add a where condition. Query equal to query plus. Query plus means select a name comma industry comma phone from account. Query plus where industry equal to I have to give industry equal to such text. Where industry equal to such text. If I write like this, what is that query you are going to get? Your query is what? Your query is going to be select name industry phone from account where industry equal to, let us say, banking. But is it a red query? The query should be what? Industry equal to single quote, banking, single quote close. But if you write like this, what is the query? Anything plus string is a string. Anything plus string is a string. So what we are getting? Where industry equal to banking. But what is the actual query we have to get? Select name industry phone account where industry equal to banking. Select name industry phone from account where industry equal to bank. This is what we need. We need to get a single quote. If you want to give a single quote, if I give single quote like this, what happens? If I give single quote, it says that this is the start of the string, this is the end of the string. It will not print a single quote. If I give a single quote, it says it's the end of the string. But what I want the single quote to be printed. Where the single quote should be printed? Equal to followed by single quote. Slash single quote. If I give slash single quote, it will print a single quote. If I give a slash single quote, what it does? Industry equal to single quote. Then we told such text. What is the such text? Bank. Again, after the banking, what I need? I need a single quote. So what I'm doing? Plus slash. Now what is the string here? Slash single quote. When I give slash single quote, are you getting my point? If you want to print a slash single quote, if I give a slash single quote, we are going to get a single quote value. Single quote in the string. People have followed. When you are writing a query, industry equal to banking. It is not industry equal to banking like this. It is industry equal to single quote banking. It is industry equal to single quote banking. Are you clear about this? People have followed. Let us give the same example. Now, public void now what I'm ready string query. String query, what I'm doing here, when I give a string query, select name, phone. So what does it mean? It is the start of the string. It is the end of the string. Whatever we wrote within a single quote is the start of the string, end of the string. Now I am giving if such text not equal to null, not equal to blank. Such text not equal to null, not equal to blank. So what I'm doing? Query equal to query plus where industry equals to. I give like this. If I give it like this, what it is going to give? It is going to give an error message. Why error message? It is the start of the string, it is the end of the string. Now what is this? If you want to join two strings, you have to write a plus sign. So when I am giving a single quote, it is not printing a single quote. It is giving what? End of the string. My intention is to print a single quote, but it is taking as what? End of the string. There is a reason I should not give slash. I should give what? Slash single quote. When I give slash single quote, what it does? When I give slash single quote, what it does? It will print a single quote. Plus, here also I have to give what? Slash. So what was this? It is going to be industry equal to single quote. What are the such texts? If I enter energy, energy, banking, banking, single quote, energy, followed by single quote. Right. Now, as of now, how are you executing the query? ACCS equal to so and so, right? But now, it is a dynamic query. Do you know which query is going to execute? If you don't enter any such text, if you don't enter any such text, only this will run. If you enter a such text, if the such text value is entered, then the where condition is coming. So are you sure which query is going to run? Are you sure which query is going to run? Depends. You may enter such text, I may not enter. If you enter, one query will run. If you don't enter, another query will run. So what is this context called? Dynamic query. Query has to be formed based on user interaction. If user clicking without entering the box, one query. If user clicks on the box by entering the data, another query. So query will change based on user interaction. That is the reason it is called dynamic sample query. Dynamic sample query. So how do you execute the dynamic sample query? I told you, ACCS equal to database dot database dot query. Are you clear about this format? How are you executing the dynamic sample query? Database dot query one. Then let us go back to the VM page. In the VM page, I am creating one more box here. Search again. The preview. Now I am not entering any data. Search again. Without going the field for type. Okay. There is a field industry comma. Search again. What happened here? List of all the records came. Now I am giving a condition, energy, search again. Now you received only the records, which are you getting my point? If you give a condition, if you give a search text, where condition is working. If you don't give a search text, there is no where condition. So query without where condition or with where condition, depends upon you, depends upon the end user. If end user is entering, one query. End user is not entering, another query. Dynamic search. Dynamic search. Are you clear about this? People have followed this example. People have followed this example. Let me explain one more time. Let me give you one more time. The basic snippet I will give you one more time. So I gave here. They give like this. What is the value we are going to get? Anything that is represented in the single quote, that will be printed. So what is the value we are going to get here? Name. If I am giving string name equal to Kiran, so what is the output we are going to get here? What is the output we are getting? Whatever that is there in the single quote, the same thing is printed. My name plus what is the value of name? We are getting Kiran. But if I want to print, if I give my name slash single quote, if I give my name slash single quote plus, what I am going to get? My name, single phone. What is the name? My name slash single quote. So it's printing single quote plus name. So what it is printing? My name slash, okay, single quote Kiran. Then I'm giving again. My name slash single quote plus name plus slash. Anything that you write within a single quote is a string. This is one string plus this is another string plus this is another string. String plus string plus string is string. So what is the output we are going to get? My name. Kiran. Because I told name plus slash single. When is a slash single quote? Single quote is created. People have followed this? People have followed this? Let me give you. What was this? The output? My name. My name plus Kiran. So what are we getting? My name Kiran. Plus. What is the next one we have? My name. Kiran. String plus string plus string. What is that? String on. I told single quote plus. First name plus single quote plus what we are getting? First name. We give out single quotes. So what is that? Space. Right. First name plus single quote is what? Is also string. What is the string? Blank space. Now I am giving like this. First name. Slash n slash double quotes plus what I'm going to get? First name double quotes slash followed by symbol. What you give, that symbol will be printed. Now according to my requirement, what I need? According to my requirement, what I need? Industry equal to slash single quote so tell me what is printed here. Industry equal to single quote banking. This is how I have created the way there will be condition. People have followed? People have followed this? Any query from anyone? And above. This is how I have written a where condition. Now, let us go to the next. I want to apply where condition based on date functions. I want to apply the where condition based on date functions. Or I want to apply subqueries. Query within a query. Query within a query. I want to apply condition. Okay, apply condition with a query within a query, subqueries. Let us see the next example. I want to go with the subqueries. Subqueries. Look at the format. I am saying, listen to the context box. Write a query to fetch all the accounts whose industry is energy. Write a query to fetch all the account records whose industry is energy. How will you get the records? List of account ACCS. Select ID. Now I want to say, second one, fetch all the contacts of the accounts whose industry is fetch all the contacts of the accounts whose industry is energy. Already I have done a query on the top. Fetch all the accounts whose industry is energy. Now whose contacts I need to get? The accounts which are in the above step. That account contacts I need to get. Get me the contacts of those accounts whose industry is energy. So what I am doing? Here I am going to use in class. What is the class we are going to use? In. So whenever we are giving a in, whenever we are giving a in with S object, it only compare ID. It is only going to compare what? ID. It is only going to compare what? ID. So what I am going to give? List of contact equal to select last name. Name from contact where account ID contact and okay look contact and account both are connected by what field? Contact and account both are connected by what field? Both are connected by lookup field called account. If the relation is a standard relation, who created the relation? Salesforce has created. We need to add ID after the field name. Now contact and account, both of them are connected by what? Contact and account, both of them are connected by what? Lookup field. What is the name of the lookup field? What is the name of the lookup field? So let me go back and show you. Contact and account, both of them are connected by what field? Lookup field. What is the name of the field? What is the name of the field? Account. What is the name of the field? Account. Account is the name of the field. Who created this? Salesforce. So add ID after the field name. So it is referred as what? Account ID. Now we have, what is this owner? What type of field is this? Lookup. Who created that lookup? Salesforce. How do you refer it? Owner ID. Created by, who created the field? Salesforce created. Created by ID. So we are going to append ID after the field name if it is created by the Salesforce. If any lookup field or a master detail field is created by the Salesforce, and if you want to refer to it, we need to add ID after the field name. We need to add ID after the field name. There is a reason I am giving here. Where account ID in, if ID of the account is in this list of accounts, then get me the contacts. Get me the contacts. Are you getting my point? Let me make it simple. It is going to be like this. Where name in what is that? If the name is Sham or Kiran or Hari, give me the value. Generally, where do you write pause? How do you write? Where name equal to Sham. Or name equal to Kiran or name equal to Hari. This is how we are going to write. There are two values, three values, okay. If there are 20 values, two values, three values, okay. If there are 20 values, we'll write name 1 or name 2 or name 3, name 4, I cannot write. Then what I will do? We will use a query of name in Are you getting my point here? Are you getting my point? So if you want to compare, if you want to check whether the field value is in that list of values, if the field value is in this list of values, when you say name in Sham, Kiran, Hari, it means name equal to Sham or name equal to Kiran or name equal to Hari. Both are same. Both are same. But if you are going with a larger set of values, I cannot write like this. I cannot write like this. I cannot write like this. Are you getting my point? So, similarly, when I say where industry in banking energy. So, what does it mean? Where industry equal to banking or energy or education. Right. Now go back. We are ready. List of account AGCS. Select ID from ID, comma, name, phone, from. Now, how many records are going to come? Are you sure? Now I told where industry equal to energy. Where industry equal to energy. When you say where industry equal to energy, where industry equal to energy, how many records are going to come? Suppose there are 500 records which came. Now what will you do? Will you write where ID equal to 1 or ID equal to 2 or ID equal to 3? Will you write all the 500 conditions? No. Then what is the solution? In. They are going to use where ID in this list of values. So what I am doing here? I am going to say list of contact cons equal to select first name, last name from contact where ID in. If the ID of this account, where account ID is in, if the ID of this account is, if the value of account ID is in this list of records, give me those contacts. Are you getting my point here? Are you getting my point? I can make an execution here. Sample executions. We got the value. Here I told, get me the list of account records where industry in, if industry is banking or energy or education giving. So what did I do? All the values whatever I want, I put them in a list. Then I told where my value, the value of the field is in the list. Where the value of the field is in the list. All the values with which you want to compare. All the values with which you want to compare. I kept all the values in a list where industry in that list. Industry in that list. Are you getting my point? Right. So the same thing I am giving as what? List of contact select ID comma first name last name from contact where account ID in AGCS. Are you clear about this point? Now the same thing, instead of writing a query like this, we can straight away write it like list of contact CONS equal to select ID comma first name from contact where account ID in I can also write it like this. But the problem with this is, you already executing a query, this query cannot be reused. If I want the same data again, one more time I will write. In another query, I want to use the same data, I will write one more query. But if I write it like this, what happened? I can reuse the data somewhere else. The reusability will be there. That is the reason, we will try to write straight away query, instead of it, we write what? Query and use in class. Now, this is also right. This is also right. But what is the difference? Here, this data I can use in somewhere else. But here, whatever the query wrote, query is running. But the data cannot be used in other operation. But this, I can use this data in other logic. Reusability is there. Concept of the mind. People have followed this concept. Clear for everyone? Let me execute one example. Both the context will execute one example. thanking. We wrote it like this. Then the first operation. Basic query ACC is equal to select ID record where industry in this is the first one. I am also writing one more method. Void subquery cons equal to select last name where record ID. Why I'm adding ID after the field? It is a lookup field created by the Salesforce append ID. ID in similarly, public void cons equal to select account ID in select ID from account where industry in where industry emails. Both are same query I am writing. As I told you, one is straightaway sub query, one is straightaway I am writing the sub query here, other one I am using. But if I write it like this, I can use that ACCS somewhere else. But if I write it like this, it cannot be reused in somewhere else. Right now. Now let us see. You want to display the data. I am recreating the VF page. People have followed that query. SQL query. Any input text. Okay. I'll make it subquery. Then along with this, I also want to display one more page bar which contain contacts. I also want to display contacts. List of contacts, whatever you are fetching, I am trying to display. But the contacts should be displayed only when rendered. What was that? Line number? Last name. D dot name. Right. So I will preview. This is the data. First initially what happened? I told you to get all the account records, whose industry is energy or education or banking, right? So these are the records which are available. Now, before I run, I want to show you the log files. What you are finding here? Under the monitor, you are finding the logs. Debug logs. create a new debug log. Right. Now I'm going to execute it. Subquery. When you run the subquery, we are getting source data. Go back to the log file. New log file. Now the time zone is different. What is the reason for time zone? What is the reason for the time zone? Go back to the user. Satish, time zone is not in IST. Go back. I'm running the query again. Right. When you're running the query, we're getting the data, first name, last name. The same, I told ACC query. When you're running the same data, we're getting. The same data we're getting. So both the queries are running successfully, but I want to show you how they are different from each other. Go back to the log files. Debug log files. Now, user log file, let's say edit. What is the time? 8:45. Make it as 0. Now you are running this. Look at the format. So we got the files here. We got success 105, success 1. Look at the view and see, we got a log file. We got a log file. How many SQL queries are running? How many SQL queries are running? When I clicked on the method, how many SQL queries? 1. I wrote a query within a query, but how many SQL queries are running? Only 1. I'll show it once again. Let me delete everything. Run it from beginning. Go back to the page. Subquery. Go back to the log file. See what is the file we got. View. How many queries are running? How many records are retrieved? 8.5. Go back and see how many records are retrieved. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Right. So how many queries are running? Only one query. I wrote a query within a query. But it is considered as what? Single query. Internally it is considered as what? Single query. Now let us go back to this. ACC query. I told ACC query. See the latest file again. So how many queries are running? Let you write subquery. Or let you write in class and this. The number of queries that is running is 1. Why I am mentioning this 1? Because there is a limitation on number of SQL queries. You cannot write as many SQL queries as you write in a transaction. In a method, there is a limitation that you have to write only 100 SQL queries. You cannot write more than 100 SQL queries. If you write more than 100 SQL queries, it throws a governing limit exception called too many SQL queries, one or one exception. Too many SQL queries, one or one exception. That is the reason we are insisting on the number of queries that are running. Number of queries that are running. Number of queries that are running. Now look at this. Now look at this. Now, instead of writing this query here, if I write the query here, now how many queries are running? 2 queries are running. But if I write it like this, how many queries are running? How many queries are running? 1 query. So if you have an issue of crossing more than 100 SQL queries, if the method is crossing more than 100 SQL queries, one of the choices is this, to reduce the number of SQL queries. Are you getting my point? Now if both are doing the same, why should I take 2 format? I can go with 1 format. But they have their own advantages. If the data which is retrieved by the SQL query is reused in another transaction, if the data that is retrieved by SQL query needs to be reused in another transaction, then I will go with this format. If the data retrieved by the SQL query is not retrieved in another transaction, then I'll go with the first, because it will reduce the number of SQL queries. People have got my point? People have got my point? Both are doing the same. At the end of the game, the output is the same, but there is a difference in number of SQL queries. There is a difference in number of SQL queries that are getting executed. People are clear with this format? People have followed? People have followed? That's all from my end for the day. Any further queries from your end?